kekasih cemburu. Sakitnya hati aku dipalu.
Hei, jangan tutup apa. Okey, Loka dah sampai dah. Cik Loka.
Guys, it's Loka B.
Hi.
Macam mana kita rapat lah? I tak ingat macam how did
dance,
it happen.
Dance.
Eh?
Yeah, dance. Can you keep up?
Oh, yeah.
Baby boy.
Yeah, so ada hari K atau hari keusahawanan. So kita orang join kelab kebudayaan. Eh no lah, time tu memang diorang buka audition.
Oh yeah. Oh, show. Oh yeah.
Show hari K. So I audition first.
Choreographer, guys. I think that was my first experience on stage actually.
Really?
Yeah, to perform
before that,
lah.
When somehow
before that tadi kah lah, aku tak boleh.
Dia ni kat sekolah dulu, dia kalau nak belajar, dia nak belajar. Kalau dia tak nak belajar, dia tak nak belajar. So macam kalau dia tak belajar, dia dapat last lah. Lepas tu kalau nak, next exam, okay aku nak belajar lah. Lepas tu dia belajar, dia dapat nombor 1, nombor 2 macam tu.
Dia ada suka hati dia. Tapi I tahu lah, you macam you ada macam you say when you want something, you say you really macam make sure benda tu you akan dapat lah. Faham tak?
Yalah, I push myself. Especially macam pasal belajar tu, mostly because bila you tak belajar, I'm busy dancing ke buat koko ke apa je lah. Tapi bila bila markah dah teruk sangat, kalau kalau admits aku pun dah E. Terpaksa lah push lah, cause macam tak nak disappoint my mom kan. My mom dia dalam education, so bagi dia sangatlah menjatuhkan air muka. Tak nak kecewa lah. For me, I didn't tak pernah terfikir yang it was an option yang I boleh pursue untuk buat performing arts.
Yelah, macam performing arts macam orang macam tak pandang sangat.
Ya, tapi it's like macam I realise that macam I could make this choice because I have two friends yang parents support diorang buat performing arts. Siti, Siti because she did theatre out of outside of school, and Nina also. So macam first time I tengok Nina dia punya musical tu, I menangis and I was like,
oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, of course lah, nangis kot aku kat situ kan, I don't know lah, third row. But it inspired me so much, and macam every time that even macam when we continue diploma, degree, I pergi UK semua kan.
Yeah. So what do you study again?
I study diploma in pentadbiran awam kat Dumun Terengganu. and then I continue my degree dekat UK, Southampton. I buat international relations macam politics macam tu lah.
How was it, you know, studying? Macam do you want to study that? So you, was it your option, your pilihan option?
No, definitely not. Cause macam I remember my parents memang strict gila babengs lah, I would say. Because macam it was to a point that macam I felt like I just give myself away because I wanted to make them happy. Macam I remember macam I sorok-sorok lah letak kat situ performing arts pun.
Oh, you taruh kan?
Ya, yeah, I taruh. My mom marah in the list.
Oh, yeah.
My mom suruh buat list 8 you nak buat apa kan? Then everything I ikut cakap dia. I buat apa entah, pembandaran apa benda entah. And then last time so ada. And then my mom was like, why? Why you want to do this?
Macam tapi you dapat, kan, masuk, kan? You dapat marah kan? To UK?
Ya, UITM lah.
Tapi okay lah. I mean, you studied. Macam you studied well jugalah.
I studied well. I got 3.5.
Yeah.
GPA 3.5. So alhamdulillah ada rezeki, that's why I lanjutkan. Itulah, tapi in making that choice, I lost myself. I completely lost myself.
Straight.
Lepas tu, live 1 year abroad. Not 1 year, as in like I live in Moscow for a whole year. Ulang alik. Then I decided that macam I cannot. I got to a point where I macam suicidal lah. Suicidal thoughts. Then I just decided one day that macam I cannot live like this. I tak boleh raise my son in with me being in such a condition.
Yeah. Was it like really bad? Like, do you had like what do you do? What happened? You know, macam masa itu kan lost tu kan?
I think macam paling teruk was itulah first macam before I had my son tu, I pergi jumpa my uni punya counselor. No, dia punya no lah, counselor lah kat situ sebab dia ada counseling service kan. So then dia suruh I pergi jumpa doktor apa semua, then I was diagnosed as clinically depressed lah. So and then it just went macam spiral, macam jatuh lah, habis jatuh, hilang diri apa semua. And then macam my exams and my final macam apa orang panggil write up thesis macam tu semua pun I buat macam
tak ada hati lah.
Tak ada hati langsung, serius tak ada hati. Itu memang itulah. And then slowly I had my son. Lepas tu I ada not baby blues, I ada apa orang panggil postpartum depression. So bila you ada
maknanya you dah depressed sebelum ada Yusuf.
Ya.
Kira lepas ada Yusuf
lagi ya depressed. Tapi macam you know, at first tu depressed yang macam tak nak buat apa, and then lama-lama it's like avoiding people, and then like macam you nak terlatar, terskatil je, not doing anything. And then you think like, what am I doing here in this life? Macam I feel like there's no point in living. And then after I had Yusuf, baru I started to think of macam like ways of ending my life lah. I rasa macam
really?
Yeah, definitely. I fikir macam-macam lah. But walaupun I tahu yang I wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
Tapi I know that kalau I tak buat something, you know, like do something about it, I akan, you know, like really do something that would affect my life lah. Macam take my life.
What stop you then? Macam when you were in that situation, you dah macam at point yang macam you dah dekat atas tu, dekat puncak tu.
Ujung lah.
What actually stop you?